That's right, man. Hit that music on mine.
I'm like the one so far away when I feel the snake bite enter my veins.
Oh, man. I haven't been back here in a while. Man, this is Hobo Tom. He's living the life, man. I'll tell you what. Then he just needs to get himself a new computer. That, he could use a woman, I think. He needs a woman's touch in this place. I'm not here to criticize, because I am the Von Breaker of men, baby. Let's see if I can get this fancy thing of his to work. I'm going to give you some predictions. Because obviously, you're not in my house. I'm in his house. And that can only mean one thing. We've got some NXT in your house coming up. Oh, man. This is a full card, too, man. What are they doing without Hunter there? Paul Levesque. My brother, man, come back to us. Let's see. Let's talk about some NXT matches. Oh, we have some honeys in this match. Let's see here. Where should we start? Let's start with that orange-haired vixen herself. Gigi Allen. No, not Gigi Allen. Who cares? She just has orange hair up top. And nothing down below. So, because we have Toxic Attraction versus Casey and Kaden. You know what? Man, they ain't going to change nothing up. This is another show before they do that Florida house show circuit. So, y'all be looking out for more videos by this one, the only Hobo Tom. You might have a few more names to add to that door of wrestling. But Toxic Attraction is going to win, man. That's a given. And then, let's see. This match is a Wanza. Rich girl. Rich city kind. Yeah. I like me some rich city kind. The other one, though, Roxanne Perez. She looks like some jailbait. But you know what? I'm not going to care because I'm going to be sipping some fine wine with some honeys that I picked up here in Daytona Beach. You don't want to know how. But you know what? Roxanne Perez, she's going to win. I would take a snooze through this match, though. Then we have, pretty deadly. There's some pretty boys from across the pond. Shouldn't they be celebrating the Queen's Jubilee? You know what? They're going to win, too, against them Creed brothers. Julius and Brutus. That's Roman or something, man. Yeah, they're going to keep them belts. Only because the Creed brothers, they have to fight. Roderick Strong and that other guy. And there will be no more Diamond Mine. Oh, well. And then in my stone cold ice cold lock of the night. Bank it. Bet the farm. Bet that sweet honey on the corner. You know who I'm talking about. You have Mandy Rose versus Wendy Chu. I'd say I live in Florida, so I've seen what a cold day in hell looks like. But it would be a cold day in hell when Mandy Rose loses that title to Wendy Chu. Mandy Rose wins in a stone cold lock. Let's see here. Then we have probably, I'll say I'll hold off to that. We have someone going to the moon. Cameron Grimes taking on Carmelo Hayes. Cameron Grimes ain't losing that North American title belt. You already promised Solo Sikoa match. Yeah, that ain't happening. Cameron Grimes keeps the North American title. And Bron Breakker. Oh, we share similar names. I'm the Von Breakker. He's the Bron Breakker. Mr. Steiner. He's going to take on, hey man, someone who I can personally get, personally commune with. I get them. Joe Gacy. You know what? This is going to be good. There's going to be some shenanigans in this match. Of all the matches, oh no, there's one more I forgot. Oops. Oh well. But for Bron Breakker versus Joe Gacy, Bron Breakker wins. And then I almost forgot about this match. This is in a different ink. This guy, Hobo Tom, he has to take better notes than this somehow. But we have Legado del Fantasma. Man, I don't want to deal with him. Those Mexican cartel. Versus Tony D'Angelo and his Goombas. I don't want to deal with the Mafia. That sounds bad. It's bad for business, man. Ain't good. But this is going to be my match of the night. You know what? Those two Goombas, they can hit the pavement. Because again, it's Legado del Fantasma all the way. Remember, they have that thick, thick Latin honey. Electra Lopez, too. That's someone I'd trade up for. But that's NXT. And I won't be in my house. I'll be in someone else. What's on, man? Can't believe it. Broken guy came in this house, man. I can smell it. That smells like swamp water, alligator guts, and bad moonshine. Oh, hello, folks. Welcome back. I have to change the locks in the house. But yeah, other than that, I'm the one, the only, I am Hobo Tom, hitting my music. And I'm here to talk about, oh, you left me a note. I already talked about Cameron Grimes to the moon winning. So yeah, I guess I don't have to talk about the NXT in your house, because God knows that guy stunk up my house. I have to change the locks, man, and hide the booze, the good booze. This is all he left me was my vitamin water, man. Do everything else. Shame. But I'm going to talk about hell, where the Von Breakker should be, in a cell. That's right. Well, WWE Hell in a Cell is this Sunday. That should be interesting. I just got back from hoboing, as you can tell. Showered up, cleaned up, tried to look a little bit more appropriate for this video, like that slob. I'm here to talk about some predictions about WWE Hell in a Cell. They might be adding some matches. I have no clue. Right now, I think even... Actually, I think that sounds about right. Yeah, so I think right now, they have all the matches that I think they're gonna have. Let me make one little note here. And MVP. So let's start off with the first match. I'll tell you what. No, that's not gonna get my matches. Oh, some of you couldn't matches. Yeah, so I'll start off with the match that I think is going to be first. And probably in the pre-show, they'll have Austin Theory versus Mustafa Ali for the U.S. belt. I don't think they're going to change those belts yet. Austin Theory just got it. Although Austin Theory has screwed over Ali a few times. Oh, you know what? I'm going to go out on a limb. I'm going to say Mustafa Ali is the next United States champion. Because I don't even... Ricochet's the Intercontinental champion. When was the last time you saw Ricochet? That's not good. IC belt used to be featured on every pay-per-view. Wow. Let's see here. Then we'll probably have the mixed six person. We have what I'm going to call Bullet Club, because they are just too sweet for life. And the reason why I'm calling them the Bullet Club is because you have Prince Devitt, Finn Balor, AJ Styles, and I guess the new Bullet Babe, Liv Morgan. I'm just going to call them Bullet Club. That way I don't have to look up all their pictures. Versus the whatever it is with Edge, Damian Priest, and Rhea Ripley. I have Bullet Club, baby, going over. Because they're just too sweet. They're too sweeting everyone. That's pretty cool, and I can take that off the list. And actually, I have to put that on the list over there. So yeah, Bullet Club wins. Not only do they win, yeah, they'll just win. Then we have Ezekiel versus Kevin Owens. I don't know. This is ridiculous. I'm just going to snooze through this match. Who really cares? They're just going to make Kevin Owens look absolutely apeshit bonkers. Ezekiel wins, finally. Then if they have this match, this is going to be my stone cold lock of the night. We have the Bloodline, the Usos. Usos! Defending the belts against Matt Riddle and Shinsuke Nakamura. Yeah, those two are a normal tag team. The Usos are going to win. Bet everything on it. Bet your last vitamin water on that. Then we'll have the women's match. It'll be Bianca Belair, Asuka versus Becky Lynch. Who is the Raw SmackDown? Wait, who's the SmackDown women's champion? I forget. Wait a second. Wow, I really do forget. Shoot. Do they even have that belt anymore? I don't know. Whatever. Asuka's gonna win. Becky Lynch is just meth head crazy. Bianca Belair. This will give her something to chase after. Yeah, Asuka wins. Bianca might not necessarily lose. Asuka might wind up pinning or submitting Becky. And that would set up something for SummerSlam. That would kind of make sense, I think. Who is the SmackDown's Women's Champion? Bianca's on Raw. Charlotte left. Sasha left. Naomi left. That's weird. I'll have to do some research. Or actually watch SmackDown. I've been working on a bunch of Fridays, so I haven't been able to watch SmackDown, so maybe that's why. And then in my match of the night, in hell in a cell. We have the American Nightmare of a neck tattoo. Oh, I'm sorry. Just the American Nightmare. The grandson of a plumber. The son of a Hall of Famer. Cody Rhodes taking on Seth freaking Rollins. You know what? Cody's going to sweep this. And this is going to eventually, I don't know if it's SummerSlam or WrestleMania, or it could even be Summer Survivor Series. Whatever it is, it's going to lay the foundation for Cody Rhodes. Actually, Cody Rhodes should get the IC belt. But yeah, eventually it's going to be Cody Rhodes versus Roman Reigns. I just don't know how far that's going to be. And they really should take that belt off of Ricochet, because he's not doing anything with it. Put on Cody. Have that belt mean something. And yeah. So those are my predictions for Hell in a Cell. It's time for me to clean up this house now. But yeah. And scrub it down. And disinfect it. And anti-monkey pox it, I guess. But yeah. But again, I'd like to thank everyone for watching. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. And I'll probably see everyone Friday. Bye. You know what? I was so concerned about who was the Women's SmackDown champion. I forgot this match. So this is a little addendum. And then I'll give my goodnight, I guess. Yeah, it's Bobby Lashley taking on Omos and MVP. I don't know if it's going to be in Hell in a Cell. It's a handicap match. Bobby Lashley's going to win. And I guess this was worth a 30 seconds of airtime. You know what? Boom goes to Dynamite. Now I'm done.